Interesting bird there walking on the pavement. Not sure what that is. Looks like he's hungry. He's asking me for some food or something. Sorry, buddy, I don't have nothing. Good morning. Friday, January 19th, 2024. 30 degrees. Windy. Got some freezing rain, sleet coming down a little bit ago. It's supposed to be coming more today. Just gonna do some walking here. Thanks for walking along. We're over here off the Greenbelt, over by the old putt-putt golf course and the old driving range, golf driving range, which is no longer in use. A little body of water right over here, some type of pond or something. I'm gonna go check that out. So this little pond here is all frozen over. If I can find something to throw on it, like a rock, curious if it'll fall right through, if that ice is pretty thick, but I don't think it can't be too thick. Let me check it out. Just throw a big old snowball on there, see what that does. Yeah. Held up the snowball, so get some idea. A lot of little slushy pools of water over here. Underneath these big power lines here. That's an interesting tree, shrub, plant, whatever it is, red in color. Even though it's freezing out here, still holding its red color. I don't know what that is. Let me get a picture of it, find out. There goes some kind of big bird, just landed on that power line up there. Let's see if I get a pick. Yeah, it's just a crow. As the crow flies. Actually have a dark sky, but the sun has peaked out a little bit. Making for some interesting lighting. Over here is the Reedy Creek. There's a woodpecker just landed on that tree over there. There he goes. Yeah, this is a little Reedy Creek here. We're at the edge of the driving range now, which that little building there, I guess, is where you would tee up your golf ball. And if you can hit this far, you're doing pretty good, I guess. That dark sky there with the sun right above. The crow sitting at the top of that tree right there. And another crow. Red-bellied woodpecker on that tree over there. think that's a northern flicker right over there. Just flew away. Here's the other side of the range on stone, they called it. When it was on operation, we got a little shack over here, mural on the wall. Let's go check that out. I guess this used to be where you would get your golf balls there, tee up, hit it as far as you could, and come over here for, I don't know exactly what this building is. Let's go check it out. That's some kind of scuba stuff on the side, painted on here, immersed. So there's the mural, some scuba helmet there, holding a net. Guess that's an octopus. Down here, there's some sea life. I know I've seen those things before, I'm not sure what they're called. Blowing bubbles. Ocean Quest mini golf. $2 ice cream. $2 small slushy. $3 for the large. 18 holes, $5. 36, $7. Got a little tiki hut over here. Another price list there. Ocean Quest mini golf. Over here, return your clubs. And you got a little patio up here. So that's that. And there is a boat. And over here, this is the mini golf course. And you got a little pond with a walrus. And there is the famous leaning snowman of Kingsport, Tennessee. If you'd like to see it, you better hurry up because the sun's out and it's going quickly. It's over here by the, that's Holston Valley Medical Center over there. We're on the green belt. What do you call a whole group of pigeons? A school? I don't know. Whatever it is, there's a whole bunch of them up there. And there they go. Some of them. A little bird was just in, right there, a little sparrow or a yellow rump warbler. I didn't get a good look at it. I got a picture, but saw several birds over here. There's one right there. There's a couple more of those birds. I don't know what they are. Can't think of the name of those things. There's a belted kingfisher sitting on that branch right straight ahead between those two branches right there. Keep looking straight. You might be able to see him sitting there. I don't know if you can or not. Got a couple pictures, but I don't know if they're any good. See if I can get any closer. A
I was still sitting on the branch right there.
Got a few photos of them. See if I can get up any closer.
So there he is,
sitting in some snow on that branch right there. And he doesn't look like he's going anywhere. Probably not enjoying this weather any more than I am. Probably ready for spring, like I am. And I got a little too close for his comfort.
A lot of little birds over in here.
We'll end the video right here. Thanks for walking along today. You have a good one. I appreciate you. Roger, over and out.
The resourceful men invent, discover, initiate. They cannot fail, for they are in the stream of progress. They are full of new schemes, new methods, new hopes, and their life is so much fuller and richer thereby. They are men of supple minds. When a man fails to improve his business, his work, his methods, he falls out of the line of progress and has begun to fail. His mind has become stiff and inert like the body of an aged man, and so fails to keep pace with the rapidly moving ideas and plans of resourceful minds. A resourceful mind is like a river which never runs dry and which affords refreshment and supplies new vigor in times of drought. Men of resources are men of new ideas, and men of new ideas flourish where others fade and decay. Originality is resourcefulness ripened and perfected. Where there is originality, there is genius, and men of genius are the lights of the world. Whatever work a man does, he should fall back upon his own resources in the doing it. While learning from others, he should not slavishly imitate them, but should put himself into his work and so make it new and original. Original men get the ear of the world. They may be neglected at first, but they are always ultimately accepted and become patterns for mankind. Once a man has acquired the knack of originality, he takes his place as a leader among men in his particular department of knowledge and skill. But originality cannot be forced. It can only be developed. And it is developed by proceeding from excellence to excellence, by ascending in the scale of skill, by the full and right use of one's mental powers. Let a man consecrate himself to his work. Let him, so consecrated, concentrate all his energies upon it, and the day will come when the world will hail him as one of its strong sons. And he too, like Balzac, who after many years of strenuous toil, one day exclaimed, "I am about to become a genius. I am about to become a genius," will at least discover to his joy that he has joined the company of original minds, the gods who lead mankind into newer, higher, and more beneficent ways. The composition of the second pillar is thus revealed. Its building awaits the ready workman who will skillfully apply his mental energies.